Good afternoon. It always ups the ante when you are introduced as a professor because it makes me look more nerdy than I really am. And it makes you think that you should suddenly sit up and listen to what I'm going to say. But I'm going to tell you something today that will change forever the way you look at your partners. So I'm going to talk to you about why women's brains are different compared to men's brains because of design. And the designer is evolution or nature. And it's pretty much a lousy designer because there are a lot of unintended consequences of design. And I'll give you some examples of why the design works and why it doesn't work. If you want to go home today and your loved ones ask you, what did you learn at TEDx today? You will learn many things. But from me, you learn about design of the X. It's the X chromosome I'm talking about. So it all began when you're about 4 weeks of conception, and you can see that in this particular video clip.
Hickory, why can't a woman be more like a man?
I beg your pardon?
Yes, why can't a woman be more like a man? Men are so honest, so thoroughly square, eternally noble, historically fair. But when you win, we'll always give your back a pat. Why can't a woman be like that?
Thank you. So, those of you who have seen this movie, My Fair Lady, which is a wonderful satire between men and women, written by George Bernard Shaw. So, in this particular scene, Professor Henry Higgins, who is a professor of English, can't understand why his muse, Eliza Doolittle, played by Audrey Hepburn, has suddenly left this mansion. He has rescued her from the gardens of Covent Garden and made her into a proficient English-speaking lady and a lady to speak, so to speak. He cannot understand why she has suddenly left him, and probably he has also fallen in love with her. And I want to, in this short talk, explain to you why there's this difference between the way a man and a woman perceives the brain. So it started at fertilization when a sperm that carries an X chromosome from the father fertilizes the egg, and you will get a female. And in the bottom, you see when a sperm carries a Y chromosome, fertilizes the egg, you get a male. I would like to focus on the bottom panel, where you see the male XY chromosome is a small blob. And it has only one thing in mind, and that is to form testicles. That's it. So there are about 100 genes on the Y, and it just is interested in forming testicles to get a male offspring, and it carries on life with one just X chromosome. So the X from the mother has about 10 times more genes, which is about over 1,000 genes, carries on all the functions of life that the male needs. And most of the time, he's okay. Except that he has no insurance policy if something goes wrong on the X chromosome, and I'll show you some examples later. So a gene, just to remind you, is just a unit of DNA that codes for a particular characteristic, like a trait, like blue eyes. Now, the female has got a double whammy of X, and that is actually too much. You have a double dose of everything, and actually it's dangerous. Well, seriously, you actually can get cancer from a double dose of genes on the X. You can get mental retardation, and so on and so forth. So it is actually not to your advantage to have both X's going. So you'll have to shut off one of them. So you do that when you're about 4 weeks after conception. So after 4 weeks, the female has to shut off in every cell one of the X so that you become an equal to the male in terms of X genes. Now you have a dilemma. You have got two X's in every cell of the body. You want to shut off one of them. Do you shut off mom's X or dad's X? So evolution, or the designer, has suggested maybe it's better to hedge our bets and shut off a mom's X in one cell and dad's X in a neighboring cell. So it's like flipping a coin, it's random. And the process is called X inactivation. It was discovered in 1961 by Mary Lyon in England. and some people call the process lionization. So here you see, in this particular movie, a shutting off of the X in all cells of the body. Thank you. So you have, at the end of this process, half of your body in females carrying mother's X and half of your body carrying father's X. So women can now should be viewed as patchy people. They are patchy organisms. Their entire body is patchy, including the brain, which is really scary. Now, something that's physical that you can see, the patchiness in a cat. When the female cat, the X gene can be for a particular color from one parent, and the X gene for the other parent is another color. So you get this tortoiseshell effect. So this tortoiseshell can only be seen in female cats, but not male cats. Male cats will just have one color. So all is well until something goes wrong on the X. And the, like I said, about over 1,000 genes on the X, including, for example, blood clotting. So in males, if you have a defect in the blood clotting gene, you very much feel the full force of the defect, and you get a problem called hemophilia. So you may recall that this was the scourge of the Romanovs with five children, where the boy, having only one X from his mother, was bleeding very frequently, whereas his sisters, the four sisters, Olga, Tatiana, Anastasia, and Maria, were able to carry on with glass half full, so to speak. So having glass half full was able to prevent the clotting problems which the boy felt. And remember, Rasputin was able to have special powers of hypnosis that calmed down Alexei, and therefore he was not in danger most of the time. Unfortunately, all of them were shot by the Bolsheviks after the revolution. So that's one example of having glass half full. And that is an unintended consequence of nature's design. This is something that nature did not think about when it designed it, that females who had a defect were able to carry on in life, and in some respects, it's a good thing. Hands up those of you who see 29. And hands up those of you who see another number. Good, there are no color. There's one there. So this is a chart for color blindness. It turns out that the genes for red color and green color are also on the X chromosome. Let's take, for example, a defect that a male has inherited in the red pigment. So the eye of these males will not be able to see red, and they will see the number 70. The female who is colorblind still has got a glass half full. Remember, in the eye, half of the cells won't be defective. So the other half of the nerve cells in the eye, they can see red, will make out a number 29. In fact, she uses the brain to fill in the black holes so that she sees the number 29, because she thinks the number 29 should be there. Just as if she looks at the word TEDx now, a colorblind female will see dots of red and dots of darkness, but she makes it all red anyway because the brain sort of tricks itself. So having the glass half full is very useful in this instance, whereas the male does not have that particular advantage of this design. As I said earlier, a lot of genes on the X code for mental function. Sometimes having the glass half full is not enough. In males, if you have a defect in this particular gene, called MECP2, you don't survive, because it is just so powerful a gene that nerve cells fail to develop and the embryo is still born. Females, because of this rescue by the other half, survive. And in fact, they live quite normally, first year, second year of life, they walk, they talk, or begin to talk, they play, and then suddenly, when the world sort of opens up in their brain and they have to interact with the world, they can't cope. And then they begin to regress, and they begin to stop speaking, begin to stop walking, and they carry on in life. And there are about 20 girls per day in the US that are born with this syndrome called Rett syndrome. So this is, again, an unintended consequence of nature's design. Now, just for a minute, let's think about other genes on the X. That's not for straightforward things like color pigment or blood clotting. Just remember that the father and mother's copy of the same gene that codes for mental function might have different strengths, so to speak. When you meet a partner, you could be musical in your X, and the dad's gene for that particular same property could be tone deaf. Now, a male will inherit mother's X chromosome, and so the male usually will either be musical or entirely tone deaf. But females will have a bit of both, because as I said in the beginning, their brains are patchy. Now, this is not something I just made up, because I actually look into the brain of females, and you can see that females' brain are patchy. I did an experiment where I placed a gene for a blue dye on the brain, and the males, you can see, is just straightforward one tone, just all blue. But females have blue patches that come from the mother and white patches that come from the father. So you can imagine that if you have a particular property on the X, let's say for musicality or less musicality, a female brain will have a mixture of both, probably producing greater tonal color compared to a male that will either be musical or tone deaf. And just to convince you that I didn't paint those stripes, I actually published this work a long time ago. So I just want to come back to this idea that if males want to look at their wives and figure out what she's thinking, it's quite difficult. But for females, you just have to talk to the mother and you'll find out why, because the male will inherit the mother's X chromosome. Thank you very much. It's been a delight to be here.